Hi Muskan.
Hi, Johnny.
So our coach for the day has joined us, everyone. So we'll wait for 2 more minutes, and would request every one of us to, if you check your respective team partners, your respective teams, your practice areas, and encourage them to join us at the earliest. We just have 120 seconds for the session to start. So meanwhile, Muskan, you can check your recorder, your mic, etc., etc.
Sure. I have actually set up my recording, so it's good. And I think my voice is pretty clear, right?
Absolutely.
Okay, I'll just present my screen as well.
Just allow us, one more minute,
Yeah, sure.
because we can see people are joining us.
Yeah, sure. I'm just sharing the screen. I'll start after you say. All right, we still have people joining us. So meanwhile, Muskan, let us take 1 minute more, 60 seconds, and I'm sure within 60 seconds all most of us will join us here. And I was thinking to do a discovery of what made you select and choose this topic. Okay, so basically, in my project, there was this requirement that we have to implement this feature of export to PDF, but at server side. So I was the one who did the some research on it, and so found this way to explain to implement it with Puppeteer. And I thought maybe if I will give a session on this, and maybe this can help someone else, because this is a very very common feature. Export to PDF is a very common feature that may be useful to someone else as well. So that is why I selected this topic, and that's it.
All right. All right. So yes, there are 58 of us. Here we are now. So let us all take this opportunity, everyone, and welcome Muskan for presenting a topic on what the name of the topic is.
Export to PDF with Puppeteer.
Export to PDF through Puppeteer.
Yes.
So I'm sure that we are going to learn something different, something new, something very exciting today. And here we are. Over to you,
Okay.
Muskan.
Sure. Okay. I think I'm facing some lag right now. Okay. So, hi everyone. My name is Muskan, and today I'll be giving a session on export PDF with Puppeteer. So, just a moment before I explained why I choose this topic, and hopefully this will be helpful to someone here. Okay. So, before moving to our agenda, let's first go through the knowledge etiquettes. First one is punctuality.
So risk knowledge session timings, and please join the session before it's start time. And other one is feedback. Please give a valuable feedback to the presenter. It will be helpful to him or her, and I can improve later on. And then please keep yourself muted if you don't have any questions, any query or something to say. So keep yourself muted till that time. Okay, so let's move to our agenda. So today's agenda, we'll first cover some basic topics, because Puppeteer is a node module. Okay, so we'll cover some basic topics first, that is Node.js, node modules, and NPM. And it will be a very brief description about them. Then we'll see what is handlebars, because in the demo today I'm going to give you a live demo, and in that today I will be using handlebars. So I'll be giving a brief description about handlebars as well. Then I'll be giving you an introduction to Puppeteer. What is Puppeteer? What are its uses? And how can we create PDF with it? Then we'll see the demo. And then I'll discuss some problems that I faced when I implemented this feature, and what could be the possible solution for that. Just hoping that it would be helpful to someone. Okay, so let's start. So what is Node.js? Node.js is basically an open source server environment. Okay, it can run on various platforms, that is Windows, Linux, Unix, macOS, and others as well. Then it basically uses JavaScript on the server, and that is what the main use of Node.js is. If we want to implement something in server side, we can use Node.js. If we want to use JavaScript at server side, we can use Node.js and then do all the work. Then Node.js is asynchronous, means that if it basically receives a request, it won't wait until its response. It will receive a request, do the work, receive another request, do the work, all the work asynchronously. Also, it is single-threaded and highly scalable. Now, here, the Node.js is basically single-threaded, and that is, it works only with a single thread. And it uses some event looping mechanism for giving the responses and making everything asynchronous. Also, as it is only single-threaded and asynchronous, it is very highly scalable, because it can accept a lot of requests at a single time, work on them at a single time, and we can scale it to an extent. So that is all about Node.js. Then in Node.js we have some node modules. Now, node module is basically a functionality organized in single or multiple JavaScript files, which can be reused throughout the Node.js application. Now, for the people who know Scala or Java, when you want to do something extra, you just add libraries for that, right? If I want to use Akka Actors, I just add a library for Akka. In the same way, we can consider it in the same way, that when we want to do something extra here and we want to use a different functionality, we use a node module. Okay? And each node module has its own context. So basically, it does not interfere with the context of any other node module or the global store. Okay? Now, I am saying that whenever I want some extra functionality, some different functionality, I will use the node module. But how will I use it? For using it, I use node package manager, basically NPM. NPM is basically a repository where we have a large number of node modules available. And it is also a command line utility that can be used to install these node modules. Okay, so for installing any node module, we simply do npm install and then the module name. That's simple. For example, today we are going to see Puppeteer. Puppeteer is also a Hamamelin module. And if I want to install Puppeteer, I'll just do npm install Puppeteer. Simple as that. And then I can use Puppeteer and all the functions available in Puppeteer in my code. That's it. Now, the other thing is handlebars. So, handlebars is basically a node module which is used to create HTML templates. And what do I mean by HTML templates here? Is, for example, I am getting some JSON data. Okay, so I am getting some data from a form maybe, and I am getting it as a JSON. So that data could be different every time. Obviously, because the form can have different data, right? So I can have a JSON different every time. Now, I want to create an HTML page with the data. Okay, so for that purpose, what I can do, I can create an HTML template using handlebars. So if you see this, this is an example here. This could be an input. This is a very small example, right? So this could be an input JSON having first name and last name. Okay. Now this first name and last name could be different. So obviously I can make it static and directly create a HTML like this. Right. So what I do, I will create a template. In the template, I will just use these placeholders with the key name, with the key basically, having first name and last name. And when I will use the handlebars, and I will compile this template with this data, and then I will get this HTML content as output. So, handlebars is basically used to create these HTML templates and then generate the HTML pages with the dynamic data that we are getting. So, and to basically install handlebars, we have the same way because it's a node module. So, we are going to install it in the same way, that is npm install handlebars, and that's simple. So, now I'm going to move to basically. Yeah. Sorry. This is just a moment, my screen is not moving. Okay, so. I'm sorry for this. Okay, so now we'll be going through Puppeteer, but before we start the Puppeteer, so do anyone have any questions till now? Anything that I explained about the handlebars or anything else?
Anyone, any questions?
And nothing right now for mine.
Okay, cool. So now I have explained you some basics that you are going to see later on in the demo, right? So now let's see what is Puppeteer and how we can use it. Okay, so according to the documentation, Puppeteer is basically a node library which provides a high-level API to control Chrome or Chromium over the DevTools protocol. Puppeteer runs headless by default, but can be configured to run full Chrome or Chromium. So this is what the documentation say. And in simple words, we can say that Puppeteer is basically providing us with Chromium to run headless at the server side. And it enables us to do all the things that we would have done on a browser at client side. Okay, so Puppeteer, so in short, Puppeteer is basically providing us a browser at the server side, and we can basically use it even headless and even with the full configuration. And here headless means that having a browser with without the UI actually. That's simple. Now, because we have Puppeteer, with Puppeteer we have this Chromium, right? So now we can do all the things that we would have done with a browser at the client side. So for example, following are the uses of Puppeteer. We can generate a screenshot in PDF of pages. We can crawl a single page application and generate pre-rendered content with it. We can automate form submission, UI testing, keyboard input. We can create an up-to-date automated testing environment. We can test Chrome extensions and many more things. Basically, Puppeteer gives us with Puppeteer we can do all of these things, right? And today we are going to focus on how can we create a PDF at the server side using Puppeteer. Simply. So this is a very basic example here that you can see, and this is the basic code that we need to generate a PDF with Puppeteer. First we need to obviously have the Puppeteer in our code, okay, and then what we will do, we will launch the browser. With the browser, then we will create a new page, and for now I am going to this site, that's not the site, okay, and then I am converting it to PDF, simply. Now let's go to the demo and see how this will behave, okay. So just a moment. Okay. So this is the code that I just showed you, right? I have actually installed all the node libraries right now because I don't have the, like, it would have taken time. Puppeteer takes like a bit long to get installed because it has Chromium as well, so it's a pretty much big library. So that is why I have already installed it. So now I'll run it. This command I can run this, and then you see we have a PDF now. We didn't have it earlier, but we have it now. Let's see what's in the PDF. You see, this is all the content that we have at the Nautilus, at the page that I have given to the given in my code. So basically it has created a PDF. Now we will move forward to our demo, and this was just a small example, but now I'll show you how we can get the data as JSON and take that data and then convert it to the PDF in whatever format we want. Okay, so I'm going to show you that. Okay, my laptop is hanging up there. Okay, so first thing, I obviously need a JSON file, right, to work with it. So let's just create a JSON file. Let's say employee.json. Okay. In this I have employee ID. Let's say we have name. We have let's consider we are getting this data from maybe some form or something, so, or by after hitting in any API, okay, we are getting this data from there. Now we are going to convert this JSON to basically we are going to take this JSON and then convert it into PDF, right? So now I have this JSON, and I told you about handlebars. So I obviously need to add this data to some page so that I can convert it to PDF later on, okay? So for that I will have to create a template. So let's create the template. HBS is the extension for handlebar file, okay? And in this we have simply, the code is much similar to our HTML code, okay? It is just we have placeholders for all the fields that we want to take from the JSON and insert into the HTML. So, for example, let's see, we have this paragraph, okay, in this I have name, and here on the placeholder I have this name attribute. In the employee.json, I have this, this key name, right? So that is why I have placed it here. Okay, let's add something smaller. And the other thing, so now I have a template as well. Now let's start writing the actual code with which we can convert this template to an HTML and then to actually a PDF. Okay. So let me have a JS. So first thing is I obviously need Puppeteer here to work with it. So I'll just here, then I need handlebars to convert this template with this data to an HTML file. So let's add it. After this, now I think these are the two things that I need at least now. So let's start writing our method. Here, first, I'll launch the browser. Okay. Then, I'll create the page. Method returns my promise. Okay, I have created the page. Now I have to set some content to this page so that can be converted to PDF. Okay, so I have this set content method, but I need to first generate this content, obviously. So let's say now for creating this content, I need to basically render my template with the data. So let's create a method. What this method will do, this method will basically will take the data, this, and take my template and compile it and generate the HTML content that we need. Okay, so let's do it. So first thing, I have to read from the HBS file, basically the handlebars file. Okay, for that I need one more import piece for using file system. I have to actually give the file path here. Okay. So let's create the path. Here I am using the path library. It will be helpful later on as well, so I am just importing it right now. So, yeah. Now, I will have the path. I don't know why my laptop is working slow right now. This should not be the case. Okay. So I have the file path now. Okay. Compile this template with the data. For that we'll use handlebars.compile method. We provide the template now first, this HTML template, and the other thing is we have to provide the data that we want to have in this template. The data is in employee.json, so I'll have to get that data here first. So from this compile method, what will happen, this data will be replaced here in this template, and an HTML file will be created. So here let's call this method. Let's pass our content and set the content here. Okay. After this, we just need to convert our page to PDF simply with the page.pdf method. here I have to provide a path. The path is basically to tell where my PDF should be created. Okay, sorry. So for example, right now I name it as employee.pdf, and that's simple. And in the end, we should close the browser, and that's it. That's simple. Let me run this code now. So I have run this code, and now you can see we have this employee PDF with us, right? Let's open that PDF. And you can see that now we have the data. Obviously, I haven't added much of, I haven't added any styling or any other thing in my HTML, but you can obviously do that. You can make this look as good as possible as you want, okay, in the template you can use CSS and HTML in the same way that you use regularly, okay. And this is how we can create a PDF using Puppeteer, and this is pretty much simple, right? Now, one thing that I want to tell you is, if you will add any CSS here in the handlebars file, right, you have to add it in the style tag here only. You can't use any other type of CSS. Handlebars does not support it, and that's what I have seen. It does not work with any other kind of CSS. You need to add style tag here and add all the CSS here for your HTML. Okay. Now, this was pretty simple, and this is how I created the PDF. Now there were some problems that I faced during the creation of the PDF, and it actually took a lot of time at that time for me to resolve them. So hopefully today I'll tell you, and it would be easier for you if you use it in future. Okay. So the first problem was loading the image. Right now I don't have any image in my HTML file, right? But that is a very common thing, that I can have images as well, and then that image will be in my local storage, right? So that can happen. At that time, with the way I am creating a PDF right now, the image is not basically inserted in the PDF. Let me show you that. Okay. So for example, I have this here. I have basically downloaded one image. Let me copy it here and I'll show you. I'll just add a image tag here simply. And okay. So now what should happen? This image should be on my PDF when I create it, right? But now we'll see what will happen. It's taking time to be here. Generally, it don't take this much time. Let's refresh this page and see if I have the image here. I don't have it, right? This is a problem that I face, and one of the solutions could be what you can do, rather than setting the content directly to the page. You can create an HTML file, and for that, let's just create for HTML file. You can basically read this content to this file. Write the content to this file. So basically, here I will write this content to this file, and rather than setting the content directly to the page, what I'll do, I'll just save a page to go to the link that I'll provide and load the HTML page from there and create a PDF from there. So here I will provide the path. And I want to go to this file now, right? So I'll just give it path here, and then I will create the PDF from this one. Let's refresh the page, and now we can see that we have the image as well. So this was the first problem that I faced. There is another problem, and that is one major problem. So it is problem with Chromium availability in Puppeteer on EC2 instances. So what I mean by this, generally after we have created this feature, we are obviously going to deploy it somewhere, right? So there could be a possibility you are going to deploy it and use an EC2 instance, right? So now Puppeteer actually comes with Chromium, and when we install Puppeteer, all those dependencies are installed at that time, okay? But when you deploy it on an EC2 instance, what happens? Some of the dependencies for Chromium are not installed due to some reasons, okay? And then your Chromium does not work, your code does not work as expected, PDF is not generated, and that is a pretty much big problem. Like you have implemented a feature, and now you are seeing that when you have deployed it, it is not at all working. Okay, so for this you can do one thing, and there's a workaround. What you can do, you can directly install Chromium on your EC2 instance explicitly. Then you have to set the Chromium path to the path on which you have installed the Chromium in your EC2 instance, and then you can use Puppeteer core instead of Puppeteer as well. Now Puppeteer core is basically same as Puppeteer. It just allows you to use a different Chromium that may be already installed on your laptop, okay? So you can use Puppeteer core. Puppeteer core does not implicitly downloads all the libraries that are needed for Chromium, okay? So now, and how will we do this? I can show you this on code deploy, but I can show you what are the changes that you need to do here in your code. First thing is, instead of Puppeteer, you need to change it to Puppeteer Core. Everything will work fine. You just have to provide a launch argument here. And in this launch argument, you have to provide the path of your Chromium wherever you have installed it. Okay, and other than that, you need to say set headless to true. And that's pretty much it. With this, you will have Chromium on your EC2 machine, right? And your code will work as expected. And the problem will be resolved. Okay. So that was it from my side. These are the references, some of the references that I have used. So do anyone have any question now? Like, I have completed the whole session. So now, do you have questions?
Yeah, Muskan, is there a reason behind the naming of this Puppeteer library? Like, what's the reason behind why its name is Puppeteer? Is there a specific reason?
I don't think so. Also, to be honest, I haven't read why it is named so. So, I don't know the reason. It's just, I know the name of the library, that's it.
Yeah, it's totally like the context of this library is not at all related to that name.
Yeah, I can totally understand that, but I haven't seen like why it is named as such.
No issue.
All right, so do we have any further questions? Anyone? Let's jump in. Let's not shy away. I'm sure you must have something to ask. Anyone?
Yeah, hi. Hi, Muskan.
Hi.
I have a question for you. I mean, suppose if we want to create multiple pages PDF, like, does this library support that?
Yes, it supports it.
Okay, and what about, suppose I have a very complex billing invoice, okay? And suppose that I'm generating a very complex invoice from my end. I'm using it for one of my e-commerce websites, suppose, just for example. I want my CSS to be as it is. I don't want to change my CSS part as well. And does this library support that as well?
Okay, so the CSS part and the HTML part, okay, that is not at all related to the Puppeteer, okay?
Okay.
Puppeteer will support it, okay? Whatever you give it as the HTML page, it will support it. It has no issues with it, okay?
Okay.
It is basically more related to the handlebars. I told you, right, that you can have the same CSS that you were having till now, okay? But it's just you have to now add it in the style tags and add it in the same page, in the handlebars page. That's it. Because the handlebars page, like, I haven't seen a way in which handlebars page work with a, I think, external CSS. We call it external CSS.
Inline CSS will work, I guess, but like, Suppose I have achieved inheritance through my CSS part, and my CSS class is being, my CSS file is defined in some other folder, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that's what my question is, because if I try to write the inline CSS for my existing code, then it will be a tedious job, right? Yeah. So that's why.
Yes, that will be, but that is like, I haven't figured out. I also tried it. Using an external CSS, because that looks much pretty and much good, obviously.
Yeah.
But I didn't find any way to use it. It is, I think, something that Handlebars does not support. It only supports, I think, inline CSS.
Okay.
So
okay.
Kind of restriction. Maybe we can find an alternative to Handlebars and then use it. this handlebars is just a way to create the HTML template. That's it.
Okay. Fine. Got it.
Okay. Any other?
Muskan, just in relation to that question only, like if it can handle the external CSS or not. So you created a PDF of noldus.com, right?
Mm-hmm.
Can you showcase it again once more?
Yeah, sure. Yes.
Yeah, so it's kind of like it's not at all pretty. So
yeah. It has just gone to that page and captured whatever it sees on that page.
Yeah, it's only capturing, I believe, the static content.
Yes.
At that point of the time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So it won't be taking any CSS. Like, since noldus.com is already an Angular app and that's a SPA, so that's why it's not taking it.
As far as I know, okay, Puppeteer is not at all concerned with what CSS you are using, what are you using, okay? This might be because the page was not loaded properly. That could be one thing, okay? For that also, we have some more options to add. Let me show you. Okay, here, for example, when we go to this file, okay, we have some options to add. I don't remember them right now exactly, okay? But we can add weight here for this file to be loaded completely, so that the full page will be printed in the similar manner, and I think that will work. I can try it and I will tell you if it works, and I think that will solve your question.
Okay. Are there any guidelines also, like from Puppeteer, to make websites more Puppeteer friendly in a way? Are there any guidelines?
I haven't read any guidelines as such. I have gone through its document, its whole document, but I haven't seen as any such guidelines.
Okay, cool.
Okay. Anything else?
Nah, that's pretty much covered. Thanks.
All right, everyone. It has been a great session so far, and I'm sure that each one of us have learned at least one thing from this session. So thank you so much, Muskan, for this wonderful session and helping us understand how Puppeteer works. So now, as it goes, that it is a very important exercise to share our feedback, our learning experience post any session. So I would recommend and urge every one of us and each one of us to share our valuable learning experience of this session. Do not take an exit right now. So we'll be here for 30 more seconds, and thereafter you can choose to drop off. So.